Hi, this is Brianette with HowRadiologyWorks.com. What we do here at this channel is we introduce bite-sized concepts in how radiology works. So just short videos. So if you're interested, subscribe and then click on the bell icon if you want to get notified when we release new content. In third generation CT, this is really where CT became very clinically useful. And this is a high level schematic of third generation CT. And in comparison with the first two generations of CT, in those two generations, there was a translation that was needed. So every view angle, every time we wanted to acquire a view, we'd have to translate the x-ray source and detector, and then rotate the whole gantry, translate, and then rotate the whole gantry. So this is what's really nice about the third gen CT. There's no translation necessary anymore. Now it's just rotation. So rotation of both the x-ray source and the x-ray detector. And third generation CT is what really survived in terms of modern CT. We'll talk about fourth and fifth generation CT architectures, but those haven't really survived. So the modern CT is really x-ray source and x-ray detectors mounted across from one another, and they're acquired in either a fan beam or a cone beam geometry, and then with or without table motion. We'll talk about that in other lectures. But as far as the high level, third generation CT is the one that really survived, won the race as far as those generations. Some people also have given names to subsequent scanning geometries, like when the table moves, give that another generation name. But in my opinion, this third generation CT is really the one that is the base of all of modern CT scanning. Again, thank you. I'm Brianette with HowRadiologyWorks.com.